Have you ever wondered how artificial meat is made? But before we dive into that, let's take a quick look at the history of meat substitutes. Our story begins in the time of 206 BC, when the ancient Chinese discovered a protein-rich, meat-like product we now know as tofu. This humble soybean curd has been a staple in Eastern diets for centuries, and it was one of the earliest known alternatives to meat. Fast forward to the modern era, and we find ourselves in a world where meat substitutes have evolved far beyond tofu. Today's plant-based alternatives are sophisticated concoctions of proteins, fats, and flavors, meticulously designed to replicate the taste, texture, and nutritional profile of animal-based meats. This booming industry, currently valued at a staggering $5.6 billion, is a testament to mankind's relentless pursuit of innovation. We've come a long way since the days of simple tofu, but how did we get here? The answer lies in the symbiosis of technology and plant-based ingredients. Over time, innovators have harnessed the power of scientific research and cutting-edge technology to transform humble plants into convincing meat substitutes. They've dissected the very essence of meat, understanding its structure, taste profile, and chemistry, and then replicated these characteristics using plant-derived ingredients. One of the most revolutionary advancements in this realm is the use of 3D printing technology. Imagine loading a printer with plant-based inks and commanding it to print out a juicy steak or a succulent chicken breast. Sounds like science fiction, right? But it's happening right now. This convergence of technology with plant-based ingredients has revolutionized vegan meat production, making it possible to mimic the intricate structures of animal muscles and fats. And the best part? It's a sustainable alternative to traditional meat production, addressing some of the most pressing environmental concerns of our time. Now that we understand the historical context, let's delve into the fascinating world of 3D printed vegan meat. From the selection of protein-rich plant ingredients to the incorporation of heme for that distinct meaty taste, we'll explore each step in this high-tech yet surprisingly natural process. 3D printing has revolutionized numerous industries, and vegan meat production is no exception. Now imagine this, transforming simple plant-based ingredients into succulent, juicy steaks or burgers. Sounds like magic, right? That's precisely what 3D printing technology is doing. This fascinating process begins with a digital blueprint of the meat structure we want to mimic. From the marbling of a steak to the grain of a chicken breast, the design is intricate, detailed, and incredibly precise. The plant-based mixture, rich in proteins and fats, is then loaded into the 3D printer. This machine, like an artist with an endless supply of paint, meticulously extrudes layer upon layer, following the digital design to the T. Each layer is carefully crafted, gradually building up the structure of the meat. The result, a plant-based meat alternative that not only looks and feels like meat, but also has the texture and juiciness of the real deal. But what exactly goes into these plant-based concoctions? Let's find out. Creating a convincing meat alternative begins with the right ingredients. The cornerstone of any meat substitute is protein, and plants are an abundant source. We're talking about legumes and grains. Think soybeans, peas, lentils, and wheat. These protein-packed powerhouses are processed, breaking them down to extract the protein we need for our meat mimicry. But protein isn't the only player in this game. Fat is equally important, adding that mouthfeel and juiciness we associate with a bite of a succulent steak or a juicy burger. So where does this come from in a plant-based world? Enter plant oils and emulsifiers. These ingredients are critical in providing that crave-worthy texture and stability to our meat substitute. Oils like coconut, canola, or sunflower lend themselves perfectly to this role, while emulsifiers help to combine these fats with our protein in a smooth, stable mixture. Processing these ingredients is a careful balancing act. It's not just about extracting what we need, but doing so in a way that maintains their nutritional value and flavor. And let's not forget, we need to make sure everything combines well to form a mixture that can be 3D printed. With our ingredients ready, it's time to create something that not only tastes like meat, but feels like it too. Achieving the right texture is a crucial step in mimicking meat. To create the perfect texture in plant-based meat, we need to manipulate our ingredients in a way that replicates the structure of animal fat. This involves a delicate balance of protein-rich plant ingredients and fat sources like plant oils and emulsifiers. Picture a juicy steak. The marbling, that intricate web of fat woven into the muscle, is what gives meat its texture and mouthfeel. To recreate this in plant-based meat, we use a mix of protein and fat. The proteins derived from legumes and grains provide the structure. The fat from plant oils creates those juicy pockets of flavor. But it's not just about the right mix of protein and fat, we also need to ensure moisture retention. Just like in real meat, water is a crucial component of plant-based meat. It contributes to the juiciness and overall mouthfeel. So the challenge lies in creating a structure that can hold on to this moisture during cooking, giving you that juicy bite every time. And how do we achieve this? Through a process of high pressure and high temperature cooking. This transforms our plant-based mixture into a texture that's remarkably similar to meat. Now, you might be wondering, how does this taste? Well, that's where the magic happens. We've crafted the perfect texture, and now it's time to layer on the flavors. Now that we have our meat-like structure, it's time to add that unmistakable meaty flavor. Ever wondered what gives meat its unique taste and aroma? Meat heem. This molecule, found in every living cell, is the secret ingredient that gives meat its distinctive flavor. But how do we get heem into our plant-based meat alternatives? The answer lies in the magic of biotechnology. Scientists have discovered a way to produce heem via fermentation, a process similar to brewing beer. They take a gene from a plant that naturally produces heem, insert it into yeast, and let the yeast do the rest. Over time, the yeast ferments and produces a lot of heem. This heem is then incorporated into our plant-based meat alternatives, giving them that characteristic meaty flavor and aroma. It's a blend of ancient brewing techniques and modern genetic engineering, all in the pursuit of creating the perfect plant-based meat. With our meaty flavor in place, it's time to bring our vegan meat to life. Welcome to the world of 3D printing, where our plant-based mixture transforms into meat. Imagine a symphony of technology and nature, harmonizing to create a remarkable facsimile of meat, all from plant-based ingredients. This is where science fiction meets culinary artistry. The process begins with loading our nutritious, protein-rich plant mixture into the printer. Much like a baker using a piping bag to decorate a cake, the 3D printer follows a precise digital design. This design guides the printer to extrude layers of the mixture, bringing our vegan meat to life, one layer at a time. As the printer maneuvers, it meticulously crafts the intricate structures that mimic the texture and feel of traditional meat. With each pass, the resemblance grows. Layer upon layer, the printer builds our plant-based meat, marrying technology and nutrition in a dance that's as mesmerizing as it is revolutionary. Fresh from the printer, our vegan meat is almost ready, but first a few finishing touches. Printing is just the beginning. Now, it's time for some culinary magic. After the 3D printer has done its job, the plant-based meat undergoes a series of post-processing steps to enhance its texture and taste. Think of this as the seasoning phase of traditional cooking. First up is curing. This step helps to firm up the texture and brings out the savory notes, taking us a step closer to the real meat experience. Following curing, we move on to drying. Drying helps in concentrating the flavors and ensuring that the meat substitute has the right amount of moisture, striking the perfect balance between juicy and dry. Finally, we come to flavoring. This is where we add those finishing touches that make our plant-based meat taste just like the real thing. Herbs, spices, and other flavor enhancers are added to give the meat substitute its unique taste profile. With our vegan meat complete, let's take a look at the future of this innovative industry. With backers like Bill Gates, the future of plant-based meat looks promising. Indeed, this burgeoning industry is anticipated to capture a significant share of the global meat market by 2054. The trajectory is clear, and it's not just because of the big names backing it. The integration of 3D printing technology with plant-based ingredients has revolutionized the production of vegan meat, offering a sustainable alternative that addresses environmental concerns. This has the potential to disrupt traditional meat industry dynamics and shift consumer preferences. Moreover, the relentless pursuit of innovation and research, such as heem production through fermentation, continues to drive the evolution of plant-based meat substitutes. These advancements are not only enhancing the taste and texture of artificial meat, but also its nutritional profile. The future is here, and it's plant-based. As we continue to innovate and improve, who knows? The meat of the future might just be grown in a lab, not a farm.